Hi guys, this is Chef Pradeep. Welcome to my channel, Everything Business and Food. This is my second video in the series of Know the Talent, an initiative to introduce talented chefs as well as to pick up some wisdom from them. Everyone knows how hard it is to run a business these days. Doesn't matter the size of the business, let alone survive for a long time. Now, it takes lots of courage, perseverance, discipline, as well as knowledge. Now, in that sense, today we are meeting someone who is successfully entering into his fifth year of the business. And he also has lots of industrial experience ranging from being a chef, production manager, business head. And he is also in teaching as a lecturer. And now he was also a marketing head, selling bakery products. Now he is an entrepreneur, running his own cafe in Hosur, known as Little England. Let's welcome Chef Pradeep Dinakaran.
Hi,
Chef. It's nice to meet you. I've been known you for, I believe, it's almost 21 years. And there's so many things I've learned from you in my earlier stage of the career. And I'm back at you to learn some more and pick some more wisdom from you. So now, as usual, I'm going to ask a couple of questions so that people also will know more about you, learn about you, and everybody can benefit from the wisdom that you have learned in these long years of career.
Thank you for inviting me in this forum. First of all, I should admit that my experience is nothing compared to what many around me have. Whatever I have gone through, I've been happy to share.
So I'm going to start with the questions now. The first question will be, how did you get into the food industry and why?
Frankly speaking, I had never thought choosing something specific as catering as a candidate. Because my grandfather, after finishing my graduation, my grandfather suggested to choose between computer and catering. And he also advised me to take help from Mr. Michael Anthony. He was then the CEO of Mars.
Okay.
He told me both had very great scope for growth and advancement. But the difference is that what he told is computer, its basics keeps changing. You need to be upgrading every time.
True.
And the advantage of choosing a catering as the carrier was, it gave me an example, like egg takes the same time to boil today. The same after 10 years or 15 years, it's only your creativity which you need to apply, and you can still do well. So, these two things.
Okay, Chef. The second question is, what motivates you to do what you do? I mean, you have to go to your shop every day, take lots of pressure, and handle the finances. So, what motivates you to do what you are doing every day?
It's a sense of fulfillment and the joy one gets out of creating or making something out of his or own hands. And it's also the passion, dedication, and the extra effort I take, my skills, and stepping up to be in par with the current trends. Both these keep me motivated. But I would also like to add that during my initial days at work, I considered myself of no value, rather say useless. And until I came across the passage, the streams in the desert, which I have a practice of reading every morning. Others may do a greater work, but you have your part to do. And no one in all God's heritage can do it so well as you. This gave me a feeling and also motivation to do something in my career, even if it is, or even if it was a little thing.
Now we are moving on to the third question. It is, what is the biggest challenge that you faced in your career till date, from apart from the pandemic? That is a big challenge for everybody, of course. And how did you solve it?
Life is full of challenges, and the present challenges are always bigger than the previous. There's an old saying, if the mountain was smooth, you couldn't climb it. That I was asked to take up the challenge at Pondicherry Hot Bricks. It was not performing well and on the verge of shutting down. I was able to turn it around with the help of my team and to make it the best performing store in the world.
It's very nice.
It is even now, and they're doing very well.
I also have been to that store a couple of times. Products were nice. Okay, what is one principle or ethics you live by, Chef?
I'll say it like this: be human, be kind, and genuine.
The two most influencing people in your career?
Wow, there are many, many, very difficult. Not one, not two. My parents, my grandparents, teachers, professors, friends, colleagues, there are many. In fact, I strongly believe that everyone in my life has taught me something, and I'm what I am today because of them all. In fact, I call it the Ubuntu effect. We are all connected.
True, Chef, but can you tell us two most influencing people from your professional side?
On the professional side, I wish to pick Mr. Michael Anthony, the then CEO of Automas. I referred him earlier too, for giving me the direction he has, and to choose bakery and kitchen as my career, and also Chef Selvaraj, for giving me the hands-on experience, and also till date for the concern and advice on my business. And some of his timely tips have helped me to keep my bakery operations healthy. I should also Chef Gerald from France. We were working with Hot Bricks, both in Pondicherry and Chennai. He was a great chef, known for his breads and choux pastry. If I may add, Mr. Muthanandam, the ex-principal of IHM Pondicherry, Ms. Amita, my production lecturer, then Mr. Rajan Pillai and Mr. Mahime Rajan, with whom I had the privilege of working with Srinivas College of Hotel Management, were also the key people in giving me great exposure to baking techniques.
I am also happy that I also came from the same umbrella of Pondicherry Hospitality Institute. What is your message to all the aspiring chefs and entrepreneurs? As you know, the time right now is, the future of hotel industry looks very grim, but we all hoping that it will bounce back, and slowly we are seeing the signs. Now, my question is, what is your message to all the aspiring chefs and entrepreneurs at this difficult time?
I would first encourage an aspiring entrepreneur to work wholeheartedly, wherever he or she is. Let's work as a team. Give a helping hand to other departments as well. This will help you gain knowledge of what the other departments do. Because when you have plans of starting your own, you're just not going to make the product. It involves other factors, other contributors. Aspiring entrepreneur, you do not have work timings.
True, you are 24/7 in charge.
Absolutely. And if you could practice it in your present time, it becomes easier for you when you take up your own projects.
Chef, it was very nice talking to you and picking some wisdom from you. And first, I would like to thank you for giving your time to come and share your wisdom with us. And Chef Pradeep Dinakaran's bakery and cafe is located in Hosur. You can also see the website called Little England. And please do visit his cafe. And Chef, hopefully once this pandemic subsides, I hope to meet you again and pick some more wisdom from you. Once again, I would like to thank you very much for giving your time to speak to us.
Thank you, Chef, for giving me this opportunity, for having this conversation with me. I encourage you all to visit my bakery, Little England Bakery at Hosur.
Most welcome, Chef, and hope to meet you soon.